Welcome back, class 10th students, in our chemistry class, and we are dealing with the same chapter, acid, bases and salts, and we are in our lecture number 10. Now in this session we are going to study about basic salt. Earlier we have studied about normal salt, acidic salt. This we will study about basic salt. What is basic salt? That replaceable hydroxyl ions by an acid. Now that is one definition, that basic salts are formed by this and this, and then how to identify, as I have told you in the acidic salt, in the basic salt also, we will be going for the same tip or trick, whatever you call. Then we have solubility of metallic salts. What salts are soluble, what salts are insoluble, which type of salts are soluble, which types of salts are insoluble. That is an important one. Then the last topic will be having the preparation of salts. So we have so many basically methods to prepare the salt, and we will be dealing with both type of salts, preparation of both type of salts, the soluble ones and the insoluble ones. And when the turn will come, then we will discuss more about it. But let's start with our basic salt. What is basic salt, with the example, definition and the mechanism also. So basic salt, what is basic salt? The definition is that basic salt is formed by the partial replacement of the hydroxyl ions by an acid, definitely. And then that hydroxyl ion will be contained in di or tri acidic base, right? So partial replacement is there. So let us see with some example. We have lead hydroxide, this is a base, and we have an acid. Now what is the acidity here of this base? Two hydroxyl ions we are seeing, so two. So there is a partial replacement, with one hydroxyl ion has been replaced and we are getting this one. Suppose we have MgOH hold twice, magnesium hydroxide reacts with acid. What is it? Diacidic base, MgOH, and we are getting. So if you want to go for the mechanism, let us see. MgOH hold twice and we have HCl. Just have a look, dear students, in very short. First ionization, again the same concept, first ionization. What it will be? Mg OH and OH minus, first ionization, right? And here we will have H plus and Cl minus. तो फर्स्ट आयनाइजेशन में एक हाइड्रोक्सिल आयन यहाँ पे टूटा अलग. Why we have the structure like this? Mg, OH and OH. तो एक O is more electronegative, so one OH and we are getting one. And in the second आयनाइजेशन it will again direct to Mg plus plus and OH minus. तो लेकिन यहाँ पे पार्शियल हमको देखना है, पार्शियल. तो we have this cation replacement होगा, तो क्या बना? ये cation इससे, we are getting MgOHCl, और ये दोनों आपस में बन गए, it will give H2O. तो देखो इसीलिए MgOHCl, we are getting this through this. This is the basic salt. फिर अगर sufficient amount मिलोगे तो second ionization में फिर reaction और आगे बढ़ेगी. But what is there? We have that partial. So this way the mechanism, you can note it down, this way the mechanism takes place. Now this is the definition of basic salt on the basis of preparation, you can say, or formed by. Now again the same thing which I was telling about, that how we will identify any basic salt. So what is the tip? That it is that which releases OH minus ion except the first ionization. फर्स्ट आयनाइजेशन में छोड़ के सेकंड, थर्ड, फोर्थ एनी आयनाइजेशन में अगर वो OH- दे रहा है तो दैट इज बेसिक सॉल्ट. और एसिडिक सॉल्ट का भी ऐसे ही था, फर्स्ट आयनाइजेशन छोड़ के H+ आयन या वो फर्स्ट आयनाइजेशन के अलावा देता है तो दैट इज acidic salt. Let us see the example. क्या मतलब है इसका? MgOH का ही ले लेते हैं, MgOH को. ये Mg हमें पहले से हम जानते हैं, तो इसको टेस्ट करना आसान है. अब MgOH Cl है तो हमें पता है कि यहाँ पे ये बेसिक सॉल्ट है कि नहीं. तो देखो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, ये बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है. Mg इस तरीके से कुछ इसका स्ट्रक्चर है, MgOH और Cl. नाउ यू विल थिंक दैट विच बॉन्ड विल ब्रेक फर्स्ट, OH वाला, ये वाला बॉन्ड ब्रेक करेगा कि ये वाला बॉन्ड ब्रेक करेगा? तो OH being more electronegative than chlorine, or you can say that O is more electronegative than chlorine, so this bond OH MgOH जो ये जुड़ा हुआ है, ये बॉन्ड ज्यादा स्ट्रॉन्गर है, राइट? तो दिस बॉन्ड विल ब्रेक फर्स्ट, इज दैट क्लियर? सो दिस बॉन्ड विल ब्रेक फर्स्ट. तो वॉट वी विल गेटिंग, MgOH plus and Cl minus. MgOH plus and Cl minus. Now this is the first ionization. And the second ionization, what will be getting? Again MgOH है तो Mg plus 2 and OH minus. तो टोटल हमें क्या मिला इसके डिसोसिएशन में? What we are getting the dissociation? एक मिला Mg plus 2, कौन कौन सा आयन मिले, फिर OH minus मिला और फिर Cl minus मिला. तो we are getting these ions. तो यहाँ पे क्या concept है कि we are not getting OH minus in the first ionization. First ionization में हमें ये मिला, we are getting the OH minus in the second ionization. So basic salts are those which releases OH minus ion except the first ionization. So this way you can just check it कि whether it is an acidic salt or basic salt. तो दोनों में वही concept except the first ionization. और बाकी जो conventional definition है by the partial replacement of hydroxyl ions, तो acidic salt and the partial replacement of H plus, sorry, partial replacement of hydroxyl ion तो basic salt और partial replacement of H plus ion तो acidic salts. Now we will go for the discussion for solubility and we'll learn about solubility of salts. Now solubility of salts or more commonly called solubility of metallic salts. Now dear students, what are salts? The basic properties we have already learned in our first chapter. They are basically electrovalent compounds, and when they are in aqueous or molten state, they conduct electricity due to the dissociated ions. Now second point is that they are non-volatile. They are non-volatile, it is an important fact. And the third one is that they form crystals, they are in crystalline form. And then we have to study about regarding the solubility, which is an important one. Now we say for certain salt is soluble in water, we say certain salt is sparingly soluble or less soluble. Then we say certain salts are insoluble. So what does it mean? So a criteria has been made to identify whether it is soluble or not soluble or sparingly soluble. So it is said that if 1 gram of salt is 1 gram of salt dissolves in 100 ml of water, तो वो क्या आएगा? Soluble salt. फिर if 0.1 gram of salt dissolves in 100 ml of water, तो ये कहलाएगा sparingly soluble, यानी कि थोड़ा बहुत soluble, sparingly soluble. थर्ड है कि अगर 0.1 ग्राम से लेस, इफ if less than 0.1 gram. If less than 0.1 gram is solvable, let's say become solvable है, is if dissolves in 100 ml of water, तो वो क्या कहलाएगा? Insoluble. तो यहाँ पे what is the criteria? कि criteria is this 100 ml of water and this amount less than. तो अगर 1 gram 100 ml में dissolve कर जाता है पूरी तरीके से, forms a transparent homogeneous solution, तो it is soluble salt. अगर 0.1 gram, तो this is the ratio by which you can have a criteria or a scale, you can say, in which you can say that is soluble, that is insoluble, that is sparing soluble. So account of this, a table, a chart has been prepared, and you can see very well in your book also, it's very well given there. You have to cram it, because after it, the last topic is about the preparation of salts. So about the preparation of salts, this is very helpful, ki you can be able to identify whether the method which I am going to prepare the salt, and when the salt is being prepared, so you can categorize it, ki whether it is a soluble salt or it is an insoluble salt. So I have also drawn the same chart which is given in your book, so we will have a look, so that you don't have any confusion when you learn, and you can easily understand it. So now we are going to study about which salt are soluble and which salts are insoluble on that criteria or the scale which we have just discussed. One thing I have forgotten to tell you about that, ki all the phenomena which are taking place there, or which takes place there, they are at room temperature, that is 25 degrees Celsius, or 25 plus 273, that is 298 Kelvin. So all we have to do the study at the room temperature, that is 298 or 225 degrees Celsius. And we are taking the normal water, that is the cold water. So on that we have soluble salts and we have insoluble salts. That's what it is in cold water. Now dear students, the first very point, all salts of Na, K, all the metallic salts which are formed by these cations, Na plus, K plus, NH4, all are soluble. अब यहाँ पे लिखा है even the sulfides, carbonates, oxide, hexoxide and phosphates are soluble. क्या soluble? Of only this. मतलब इसके सारे दुनिया के सारे salts सब soluble हैं. Na plus, K plus, NH4. क्यों ये लिखा हुआ है even the, क्योंकि sulfides, carbonates, oxides, hydroxides, phosphates ये insoluble होते हैं. बाकी other cations के सिर्फ Na plus, K plus, NH4 plus K soluble होंगे सारे salts, लेकिन rest क्योंकि last में हम अभी ये देखोगे तो clear हो जाएगा. फिर all nitrates and nitrites are soluble, जितने भी nitrates and nitrites and metallic ions के. All bicarbonates are soluble except KHCO3, NaSO3, ये क्या sparingly soluble. Rest all sulfates are soluble. एक्सेप्शन क्या है? लेड SO4, PbSO4, AgSO4, CaSO4 और बेरियम सल्फेट. ये सारे सल्फेट जो हैं इनसॉल्वेबल है. कैल्शियम सल्फेट, AgSO4, लेड सल्फेट, बेरियम सल्फेट, सिल्वर सल्फेट. देन ऑल क्लोराइड्स, आयोडाइड्स, ब्रोमाइड्स, यहाँ पे दो चीज है ऐड हुई है, आयोडाइड और ब्रोमाइड. ऑल क्लोराइड्स, आयोडाइड्स, ब्रोमाइड्स आर सॉल्वेबल. व्हाट इज द एक्सेप्शन? PbCl2, AgCl, NgCl. वहां पे भी एक चीज याद कर लेना कि जो PbCl2 है, इट इज सॉल्युबल इन हॉट वाटर. इट इज सॉल्युबल इन हॉट वाटर, राइट? तो देन वी हैव ऑल सल्फाइड्स, ऑल कार्बोनेट्स, ऑल ऑक्साइड्स, ऑल हाइड्रोक्साइड, ऑल फॉस्फेट्स आर इन सॉल्युबल एक्सेप्ट ऑफ यहाँ पे भी लिख दे रहा हूँ समझने के लिए, Na plus, K plus and NH4 plus. तो बेसिकली जितने भी सल्फाइड्स होते हैं, कार्बोनेट्स होते हैं, ऑक्साइड्स होते हैं, हाइड्रोक्साइड, फॉस्फेट्स होते हैं, इन सॉल्युबल होते हैं एक्सेप्ट. तो यू हैव टू क्रैम दिस टेबल. because it will be very helpful in identifying when you go for the preparation of salt whether it is soluble or insoluble. Now, as far as preparation of salts is concerned, so in the 9th class, in the 8th class, we have studied basically 5 methods for the preparation of salts. First is synthesis or combination, then we have displacement or replacement by on reacting with dilute acids. You, if you remember the activity series, the reactivity series will come to play its role. Then we have in this, in preparation of salts, we will be having not exactly the decomposition reactions, preparation by decomposition reaction, but preparation by displacement reaction followed by decomposition reaction. When I will draw the table, when I will draw the chart, then it will be more understandable to you. Then we have double decomposition reaction. Double decomposition reaction mein kya hai? Ki we have to study all the things, both type of reaction, precipitation reaction, usme insoluble yaad hoga banta hai mostly, and then we have the neutralization reaction, neutralization by base of an acid, then neutralization of alkali with an acid, jisko titration bolte hain. To ye table bana ke samjhaunga, so that will be more easy for you. So now that's all for today, and in the next, and one thing more, कि ये सारे जितने प्रिपरेशन हैं तो कुछ सॉल्वेंट सॉल्ट्स बनाएंगे, कुछ इनसॉल्वेंट सॉल्ट बनाएंगे, और यहाँ से भी हम उसको पहचान सकते हैं कि कौन से इनसॉल्वेंट्स. सो दैट इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट पार्ट, दैट इज द लास्ट पार्ट ऑफ दिस चैप्टर, एंड यू हैव टू प्रिपेयर इट. एंड देन वी हैव सम मेथड्स इन प्रिपरेशन ऑफ स्पेसिफिक सॉल्ट्स, तो उसमें बहुत ज़्यादा कुछ नहीं, वो आपको बनाना होगा, प्रैक्टिस करना होगा, याद करना होगा, रटना होगा. उसमें समझाने जैसी कोई चीज बहुत ज्यादा नहीं. जितना एक्सप्लेनेशन था यहां तक था, फिर अगला जो हम प्रिपरेशन का जो चार्ट देखेंगे वो है. सो इट विल एनेबल यू टू अंडरस्टैंड बाय योरसेल्फ. सो डियर स्टूडेंट्स, गो फॉर द सेल्फ स्टडी, लर्न इट, प्रिपेयर इट, एंड ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड एंड ट्राई टू कवर द कोर्स फ्रॉम योर साइड ऑल्सो. सो दैट्स ऑल फॉर टूडे. थैंक यू वेरी मच.